Well, I just pulled into a site at Lewis Lake Campground here in Yellowstone, and the lady at the front told me there's 84 sites, and I'm currently only the second site occupied. So you can probably tell why. It's pretty snowy here. Let's go take a look at the site. It's on the back side, so I drove around once when I got here. And these are my footprints from earlier. But notice that this site has firewood. It's a free firewood. That's always a benefit. It appears there's about a foot of snow on the picnic table. So I'll have to clear some of that off. But at least there won't be any risk of wildfire today. At least the snow is pretty fluffy here. So that shouldn't be a problem. Hard to tell what's going on with the fire here. This is a rock fire pit? Yeah, there's just rocks around the edge, I see. I had a fire at one point before the snow. Brought a snow shovel with here. Well, that won't go in. There we go. Nice. Nice little grate there. That'll come in handy. Log. That's not getting burned. But this can get burned. Nice. Some other wood here. Looks like pine. I have to go for a hike and see if I can pilfer some wood from some other campsites. We'll see. It's just a rock. It's another log. There's a chunk of wood. Very good. There for some reason. Grab that. So far, so good. Figure out a good place to set the tent. That's the next trick.
Well, I have to admit, I was a little bit nervous thinking that the campground might have filled up here, but apparently that's not the case. There is only one other person in the entire campground, which is pretty awesome. In the summer, I'm imagining that this would be very full. Hard to get a site. But today, I think, is October 15th. They close, I think, in a couple weeks. The campground's closed for season in a couple weeks. So I'm right at the tail end here. It does look, as I'm walking around, like there has been some use. A couple sites here and there have tracks, but no one in there currently. That might change. It is a Friday night. Ooh, I see another piece of wood over there. Grab that. And for anyone wondering, yes, I am carrying bear spray. Bears are bound to be a little hungry this time of year, so protection here. I'm gonna grab this wood over here. Oh, I lied. That is just a log. Wood, but not carryable or burnable. Might have been lucky with the only site that came with firewood. Sweet. Well, unfortunately, my further endeavors there in firewood scavenging were fruitless. So this is what we're gonna have to work with for now, which I think will be enough for a fire tonight. I've got some scrap cardboard and some scrap paper in the vehicle. That'll provide some good tinder, and I could probably scavenge some other branches here. It's pretty heavily forested, so I'm sure I can find some other stuff, but this will get us going for now, so I'm happy with that. I think I'm going to kind of plot out an area for the tent. This site is kind of on a slope, so not the best for a tent. Behind the camera, actually, there's a flat spot, so I will probably carve out a section there, set up a few things, and I'm probably going to take off out of here. I think sun's going to set maybe about 7 p.m. It's currently, I think, 1:30 or 2. So I'm going to head up deeper into the park a little bit, maybe check out Old Faithful. If there is firewood up there, maybe see what the price is and then make a decision there. Then hopefully find a visitor center that's open, because I came in the south entrance south of the park and no visitor center yet. So yeah, that's the plan. We'll see how it goes, see how far I get up into the park before I have to turn around. Probably want to make it back here maybe 5:30 or 6, so I have some time to set up, get a fire going before it gets dark out.
And just to show how deep the snow actually is, I'm not making this up. This is my hand, big gloved hand. That's at least a foot deep up to there. Crazy. Feel the heat from here. That is boiling water right there. Impressive. Smell it too. Smell like sulfur. This is called Heart Spring because it's roughly heart-shaped. I don't know if the camera picks it up, but it appears to be quite deep. At least 8 to 10 feet. I can't even see over the edge. It's pretty cool. Obviously, very hot. And this one is called Ear Spring, like the ears on the side of your head. Again, because it's shaped like an ear. You can see it's boiling there right in the center. It's pretty cool. It's got some cool colors on the outside too. Calcium and iron build up.
not too easy starting a fire on top of the snow. But I think we'll manage here. Go gather a few more things. But it should be pretty good shape. Good. Well, while the fire burns down, it's time to get this tent set up. My accommodations for the night. I think, yeah, the ground cloth separate here. It was dirty last time. I had to wash it. Move that out first. So that's how that goes. Looks good to me. Sleep on the snow, but not in the snow. There we go. Done. Fire is proving difficult to keep going. That's what you get for free wood that was buried under snow. This seems to be working pretty well. Just get this wood to dry out, catch fire. We'll be golden. I think we're almost there. Long enough. Whew. I'll say it's not super cold yet. Probably still just 30 degrees or something. There we go. Clean all this stuff. Start the pot. There we go. Of course, it's at the bottom. Got pork and beans. Seem to have gotten crushed. Not sure what happened there. Altitude difference, maybe? And a rice dish that I made earlier. Yeah. Pour that in. That warming. And put the pork and beans in as well. This one likely has a pull tab. So I don't have to worry about trying to open it. Cannon. Give that a good stir. I'm gonna add just a little bit of water to this. Keep from burning. Although, I think I'm gonna have much problem burning if this fire doesn't stay going.
little bit of water. Help with the heat transfer.
Alright, this is looking... Ooh, I can hear it sizzling. Looking pretty good. It has not started burning yet, so that's a good sign. I'm gonna rotate it, I think. Ooh, that's hot. Like that. Rotate it a bit there. I'd say that's almost done. Really just need to be heated up. There's not really any cooking involved. Alright, so I got it in a burrito here. So we got pork and beans. There's corn, rice, cabbage, and some tomatoes in there. So it should be a delicious meal. Enjoy it by my dying fire. It's not dying, it's just going very slowly. Well, I adjusted the fire a little bit. Able to get some more burn out of it. So I'm going to sit here a bit and see how big I can get it. Probably not much bigger, but at least it's throwing some heat now. But as you can see, the sun is now down. It's getting dark out, so I'm probably 10 or 15 minutes away from crawling into the tent and getting set up for bed. Because it's getting cold. Well, the fire fired back up. Just got the logs burning now. It's making kind of a cool glow on the snow. Cool shadows. So, I'm gonna stay out here a little bit longer. Probably gonna regret that later. Alright, I think I am ready to turn in for the night. So it's supposed to get down about 10 degrees Fahrenheit tonight. So I've got my sleeping pad, my 0-degree sleeping bag, sleeping bag liner. I'm wearing 2 pairs of pants, a shirt, a long sleeve shirt. I'm also wearing gloves. I'm going to be wearing a hat. And I got a wool blanket on top of my sleeping bag, plus the 3 jackets that I had along, or sweatshirts that I have along. And I'm also going to be wearing a mask to keep my nose warm. And then another blanket to cover my head. So hopefully that does the trick. It's not windy right now, so that's a good sign. But I guess we'll find out in the morning how cold it actually got.